Hello friends, press the subscribe button and hit the bell icon for more such easy videos.
Hello friends, in this video we are going to learn the full forms and the various denotations of plasmids. Here we are talking about plasmid, that is E. coli cloning vector PBR322. When I use the word P, it's a small alphabet, it indicates plasmid. B and R basically is the name of the scientist who came up with this PBR322, that is Bolivar and Rodrigues. When you talk about 322, actually 322 is the number that has been given by the workers. So PBR322, the name of this vector, came with such reasons. Remember, whenever we are denoting plasmid, it is denoted by small p, where the B and R indicates the name of the scientist. In that way, we have PUC also, where small p, capital U and capital C comes into picture. Small p indicates plasmid, UC indicates a place where plasmid has been discovered. So it is University of California. Now whenever we are drawing plasmid, we remember the short forms, but it's very difficult to remember the full forms, and most of the full forms are not given in our NCERT books also. In this video, I will be covering the full forms of all the possible enzymes, the markers, with respect to Neet. So here we have the first one, we always indicate it as ORI. Now when I talk about ORI, logically what it means it is origin of replication. Origin of replication means the point from where the replication of the plasmid will start. We have the next denotation. So remember, whenever we talk about ORI, it is origin of replication. And the next part, that is next to the origin of replication, we have something called as ROP. Now whenever we use the word ROP, so most of the time we are confused at what exactly is the full form of ROP. So remember, ROP stands for repressor of primer. So it's the point where the primers actually get repressed, and in this ROP we are going to get one enzyme, that is PVU2. What exactly is the PVU2? It stands for Proteus vulgaris 2. So Proteus becomes the genus, vulgaris becomes the species, and 2 becomes the order of discovery. So second to be discovered is the Proteus vulgaris. And this area, what we are taking as a bigger area, that is a green shaded region. So this area marks various enzymes. Let's take here, it stands for SAL1. So what is S, what is AL, and what is 1? When I say S, S stands for Streptomyces, that is the genus. When I use the word L, it stands for Albus, it becomes a species, and 1 is the order of discovery. And in that above we have BAM H1. So what is BAM H1? B stands for the genus, that is Bacillus. AM stands for the species, that is Amyloliquefaciens, and H is nothing but the strain, and 1 is the order to be discovered. So what is BAM H1? It is Bacillus Amyloliquefaciens. And this area that I am marking in the orange shade. So in exam you should know the full forms of these small enzymes. Here we have the receptors present, and it is for HIND3. So logically what HIND3 stands for? H stands for the genus, that is Haemophilus. IN stands for the species Influenza. And D stands for the strain, that is RD13, and 3 is the order to be discovered. We have the another one, that is CLA1. So what exactly CLA1 stands for? C is the genus, which indicates caryophenol, and LA stands for latum. We have the next one, that is ECOR1, that stands for Escherichia, that is genus, cola is the species, R is the strain, that is RY13, and 1 is the in order to be discovered. So these are the positions of various enzymes on the plasmid, and it's very important for NEET exam. Next we have PVU1, which we already did, Proteus vulgaris. We have PST1, that stands for Prodiventia stuarti. And in the plasmid we are having antibiotic resistant gene. One is AMPR, that is ampicillin resistant gene, and we have TETR, that is tetracycline resistant gene. So in this way you can remember the full forms of all the enzymes. The method to remember the shortcut of the plasmid I have mentioned in another video. So the link is given in the description. Till then, this is Sunil sir saying goodbye to you. If you have understood the names of the plasmid, don't forget to give a like.